Hi, my name is Mae Bulburn, and I'm a Board Certified Behavior Analyst with DiNovi & Associates. In this video, I'll be talking about Area G5 of the BACB Fifth Edition Task List, Use Modeling and Imitation Training. A model is when the antecedent stimuli is identical to the response. Imitation training is when the response is topographically similar and temporally proximal to the model. Everyday example, things you learn to do just by watching someone else do it, include imitating a hairstyle, a joke, and using the microwave. Teaching imitation can be completed through discrete trial instruction or through naturalistic teaching. In the text of work in progress, Leaf and McKechnie developed a nonverbal imitation checklist. It's a resource that categorizes imitation into various subsets that systematically become more complex, beginning with object manipulation and then moving to motor imitation, then increasing distance, 2 to 3 step directions, discrimination, and chaining as well. Generalized imitation is observed when imitation of a model behavior occurs across various settings, even though the imitative behavior is not reinforced and can therefore increase the rate of acquisition of novel behaviors. So why is imitation important? Imitation is present in neurotypically developing infants. Imitation in infants and very young children support empathic responses, foster independence, and aid in the development of speech and language. Imitation plays a pivotal role in rapid acquisition in novel behavior in humans. Imitation also serves as prerequisite skills to teaching more complex responses and social skills. Here are some examples. In the Ingersoll and Schreibman article, they highlighted social benefits and generalized advantages to teaching imitation during naturally occurring opportunities. The treatment consisted in 5 phases, starting with recognition of imitation or contingent imitation and ending with imitation of novel actions. For some participants, there was a significant increase in spontaneous language. In the Kleberman-Miranda article, the researchers described problem solving as an extension of social responsiveness and as a social navigation skill. This refers to imitation being used as a social problem solving. For example, if a student is unsure of what the expected response, he or she can refer to a peer. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel, and to disseminate the science, share this video. Thank you, bye.